kids. Good chat. Thanks, Dave. Now, imagine going to the doctor after giving birth and being told you need to go on a diet. Well, our next guest, Kasey Edwards, experienced what's become known as fat shaming. And she joins us now along with Dr. Rick Kausman. Good morning to you. Kasey, tell us what happened when you went to the doctor. What was said to you?
Well, I went to see my doctor about something completely unrelated to my weight. I didn't even raise the subject. And at the end of the consultation, she suggested that I see a dietitian to help me lose weight. So just by looking at me, my GP had decided that I was overweight and that I was unhealthy.
Wow.
During my consultation, she didn't ask a single question about my history. She didn't ask about my pregnancy. She didn't ask about my lifestyle. I mean, I exercise regularly. I eat really well. My blood pressure is low. A few months ago when I had my blood tested, my blood sugar is in the healthy range. So I am healthy. And yet her rash diagnosis was that I was unhealthy and that I needed to lose weight.
Well, you look pretty amazing to me. Dr. Rick, what do you think? Was Kasey's GP out of line?
Yes, look, this is a tricky area, but the situation is not uncommon, unfortunately, Deb. I've heard so many stories from many patients over time. You know, one of my patients once said to me that she was visiting her endocrinologist, and her endocrinologist said to her, you know what I'd do with people like you, talking about people of a bigger size? I'd lock you all up. That'd fix you, that sort of stuff. And so we're getting so much fat shaming or what's called weight stigma that it's very problematic. It's very, of course, it's inappropriate, but it actually makes it harder for people to look after themselves in the healthiest way that they can.
The reality is, though, that obesity is the single biggest threat to public health in Australia, and we are ranked as one of the fattest nations in the developed world. Doctors have to try to tackle this issue, don't they?
Look, first of all, we've actually got a bit off track here in terms of, you're right, the focus has become on the so-called obesity and on weight, but it's become very unhelpful because, of course, weight isn't a behaviour. It's the things that might be causing us to become above our most healthy weight that's the key thing, and that's where the focus needs to be. So rather than focusing on weight, as I've said many times, and a friend of mine has this lovely phrase of that we're focusing on the wrong W. We've been focusing on the W for weight rather than the W for well-being. Now, if we can shift that focus, it's much more helpful, and we definitely decrease the chances of someone feeling not heard in a consultation. And why it's so, I'm excited about the situation that's happening now to make changes in general practice. Next year, I'm teaming up with APNA, which is the Australian Primary Healthcare Nurse Association, and we're doing training for practice nurses across Australia next year. So I think this is going to make a significant difference to patients' experience coming into the general practice so they can be cared for in a much more holistic way.
Now, Kasey, you wrote an article about your experience and you got a lot of support, but you also copped a fair bit of criticism. One person wrote, "You're doing your sisters a disservice by validating that it's okay to never address their weight issues, which desperately need to be addressed. And this too, your article is sick and will damage and potentially kill people as doctors get scared of being sued for doing their job." A little bit over the top, some of the criticism, but I guess there are valid points. Shouldn't doctors be able to address health issues?
I actually don't think that they are valid points. Because firstly, what my doctor did with me was absolutely break the trust that we had. Now I will never feel comfortable taking my clothes off in front of her to have a pap smear, a breast exam, to get a mole checked, because I know that she will be scrutinising and judging my body.
But isn't a doctor's job to actually address health issues like this? It's sort of they're damned if they do, damned if they don't.
If it is the job of doctors to reduce obesity rates, then by any measure, they have failed at that spectacularly. Doctors have had the same approach for 50 years. And as you said, we're continually told we're in the middle of an obesity crisis. Now, what I did in my article was write about an alternative approach, one that is grounded in research and in compassion. And the fact that doctors personally attacked me for suggesting that there was an alternative approach to an area of health that has has room for improvement, I think is symptomatic of the whole problem that I raised. The arrogance and the hostility of that just shows that these doctors are not listening. They're not listening to their patients, and they're not listening to the research that shows that they need to find a different way to address this area of health.
So, Dr. Rick, what do you think GPs should be doing instead? Because a lot of people criticise doctors for not trying to tackle problems before they arise related to obesity.
Yeah. Well, again, the important thing is that this is a tricky area of health, and unfortunately, this has happened quite quickly. This change in society across the high-income countries around the world has happened just over the last 30, 40 years. So the training at undergraduate level and postgraduate level is almost nil. An hour or two at most. So, unfortunately, most doctors aren't well equipped to discuss this issue. And because there's so much pressure on doctors to see lots of patients quickly, they're taught to be proactive, then they will bring issues up, but they often haven't got the language to do it in a sensitive way.
Yeah.
Part of what Kasey wrote about was in fact, handling this in a better situation. We want to help people to be the healthiest they can be, but it's the way that we do it that's so important.
Yeah. All right, well, it's an interesting debate, and Dr. Rick and Kasey, we thank you both for joining us this morning.
It's a pleasure, Deb. Thanks.
Thank you.
Yeah, interesting topic. Love your thoughts as well. Send it in, email, Twitter or Facebook.
Absolutely. Coming up, though, life on...